2011, and he, in this short time, 6 years is really a short time from a running perspective, but from 2011 he's done 18 plus ultra marathons. How many know what is an ultra marathon? Oh, what is it? Yeah, 42 kilometers is a marathon, and anything longer than 42 kilometers is an ultra marathon. Okay? And how much is everybody going to run on 10 kilometers? That's right, that's 1/4 of a marathon. Okay? So, coach has run 18 plus ultra marathon, which is 18 days. He's also run the Comrades, which is, you know, one of the most toughest endurance runs in the planet, and he's done it back to back, which means that he's done one Comrades after the other. The Comrades is an 89 kilometer run, which happens in South Africa. He's run about 52 full marathons and several half marathons, and no, at that level you stop counting your 10Ks, okay? Because it doesn't matter, when you just get warmed up, you already done your 10K. He's also a certified fitness trainer from ACE, and he trains endurance athletes, and he also trains badminton players. So, coach is going to tell us what to do in the next 48 hours. From now till race day morning, and then for another 24 hours after race day, how to recover. So over to you, coach.
Thank you so much, Mr. Venkat. Good afternoon, everyone. How are you doing? All right, can you hear me now? All right, thank you so much for Venkat for the introduction. I thought I was going to spend a lot of time on that. As Venkat mentioned, I'm a certified trainer from ACE. And also, I'm a road safety ambassador. You can see the shirt that I'm wearing, the Be Safe and Be There to Save. It's a small mission, small attempt to bring in a positive change in the road users, and also the safety of the pedestrians, safety of the people on the road. Then in terms of my running credentials, these are all the little posting guides that you get, and I'm sure all of you are going to proudly display your medal as well as the badges and the pictures and the selfies at the finish line after you finish your 10K event tomorrow. And then, so this picture that you see towards the right is the avatar of me running on the road and also spreading awareness, talk to people about the importance of road safety and also following safe driving habits. I've completed a mission of running 42 kilometers on 42 weekends, 42 different places, starting way back in July last year, completing this mission in July, April this year. All right, now let's get started. Are you ready for the next 30 minutes? 30 minutes is a short time, but you know, we have got an action-packed content, very important information. Actually, I'm going to share my own experiences of how to approach a race, a short race like 10 kilometers, and how you need to prime your body and how you need to get there. Okay. Let's get started. Now, the question to all of you is, how many of you are first timers here? First time running at 10 kilometers? Anybody out there who's just walking inside, are you a first timer? It looks like all our experienced runners here, okay? Makes my life simpler. So running is a lifelong journey. All of you know that running is one of the fundamental movement that all of us can comfortably do, right? From the kids to adults to even if you are 85 years old, you can run or walk, and the movement is really, really important. And basically it's a very, very healthy habit to have. So if you're the beginner, first time you're going to run your 10K event, you're on to a big start, okay? Now, the one advice that, you know, it's a kind of wisdom that comes over a period of time. I've attempted various forms of races, right from short races to long ultra marathons. And always I realize that because it's a lifelong journey and I don't want to get everything right on the day one. Okay, so that means if you're not getting your personal best today, don't worry about that. There is going to be another 10K event that is coming. All right, now, very important thing is the knowledge, right? The knowledge is really, really huge. Like for example, this event, 10K event, for many of us, you know only a little. The known elements about this race is very, very little. You know, you can control, those are the factors that you can control, but a lot of things are unknown. On the race day, even if you're a well-prepared runner, you have trained really hard enough and you're ready to actually take on this 10 kilometers, something can go wrong on the race day. Okay, so the unknowns are so much. You can feel so confident that you're prepared really well. Something can go wrong on the race day. Okay, so that's why it's called as the unknowns. It's like unfathomable. It's like a huge iceberg. What you see visible is only the small portion on the top. But what you don't see is it's really, really unmeasurable. Okay. Now, if you see that, there is a red, yellow, and green signal that I have put here. There are many things that you will stop doing because these are some of the bad habits that you can. Okay, let's say you've run a 10K last time, something went really wrong, but you're aware of those bad habits, then you must stop doing that. And then the yellow is basically continue to do that. Anything that you continue to do because you're very successful doing that. Okay, and then the green one, you can see that these are some of the new habits that you need to start because you unlearn something and you're also relearning, you're applying those learning into this particular event that is 10K that is going to happen in 2 days from now. So now, why this next 48 hours are really, really crucial, right? So you might ask this question, why 48? Why not, you know, the next 1 month? Right? So the 48 hours are really considered to be crucial because of these reasons. You want to achieve something really cool today. Okay, so when you get under the start line, you feel that I'm going to break my personal record because running is a very, very individual sport and I want to really break my personal record and I want to achieve something cool. Maybe you're running 10 kilometers for the first time in your life. Okay, so you want to achieve something really cool. And then very important thing is to prime the body. Now we'll talk about priming the body a little later. So that's the reason why we are here. You want to feel fresh and really, really strong. Not so sluggish at the start line, you don't want to feel really sluggish. Okay. You want to be so active, so energetic, feel as if nothing has happened. You're well-rested body and you're ready to give your best performance on that day. Okay? And then very, very important thing is to feel, and I am sure the race day ambience is going to be phenomenal. There's going to be music, there's going to be 23,000 runners around you, and it's going to be very, very energizing moment, and you need to stay motivated. There is no reason for you to feel low at the start line. Okay? So it's so important here. And then very important thing is you need to stay relaxed after the run. Okay, you've given your best shot and you've finished the race, and after the race you want to basically recover very well because your body is going through a torture. Okay, and then very, very important thing is not to do anything stupid. Okay, so I use the word stupid. I love that word because I've done many stupid things in my life, including running marathons under trained, not so very well prepared, being at the start line with an injury, thinking that I'll give my best performance. So these are some of the stupid things that you want to avoid. You know, that is what I'm going to cover. This 48 hours are really going to be important. Now, 2 days from now, that is going to be already done, right? 2 days, Sunday, by this time, you're already relaxing, thinking about what really happened on that day. Now, up to this point, what is that you should have done? Now, looking back in time, 14 to 16 weeks, usually that's the kind of time that you need to give for training to give your best performance in any event for that matter. It's a 10K event, 14 to 16 weeks prior to the event is when you basically start planning. Okay? Now, you've trained, you've conditioned your body. When I say condition, there are a lot of different ways to train your body. Running means it's not just running, but also strength training. You need to do some power workouts, some cross training, cycling, swimming. There are different ways of training and conditioning your body. It's really important that you condition your body. And then tapering. Tapering is about the last probably 2-3 weeks. You cut down your mileage. Okay, you are not running the same amount of distances because you need to allow the body to rest and recover. You need to taper. You need to go down on the mileage so that the body gets adequate time to recover and basically you're going to give the best performance on the race day. And stretching is really important. We know that flexibility is really important and limitations are known. The reason why I've listed is each one of us is very unique and you really know what your limitations are. Okay, that let's assume that you have certain injury, you're carrying some injury. Okay, during the training something went wrong, you had a ligament tear or you have a stressed calf, or maybe there is a stress injury that you're carrying, or muscle is still not recovered from injury. So you're aware of those limitations. Okay, and then you have tested the race conditions. What does that mean? Let us assume that tomorrow, how many of you are going to run this race, let's say around 1 hour time? You have a plan? 1 hour time? Let's say 2 hours? 1 hour?
1 hour.
1 hour, okay. So
Venkatesh here, he's going to run the race in 1 hour. 1 hour, Bangalore is about 900 meters elevation, okay?
And tomorrow, all these days, the last few days, it's been raining.
There's humidity levels are going to be really high. Have you really run at least 6 to 8 kilometers on the race pace? Let's say tomorrow you're going to run 1 hour, means 6 kilometers, 6 minutes a kilometer. That's the pace you need to run, so that 60 minutes you finish your 10 kilometers. At least at the 6 kilometers, 6 minutes per kilometer pace you have run, at least about 68 kilometers, you're confident about that. And then you knew the event, you know the course, you need the kind of conditions, you're really aware of the event. And then you have a goal and a plan. All of us have a purpose. Sometimes having fun is also a goal. Okay, just go and relax and enjoy the event, take some pictures, talk to people, cheer other runners. So that is also a goal, and you have a plan on how you will start, what is the pace for the first few kilometers, how you're going to progress, how you're going to reach the finish line. That is the plan I'm talking about. And again, you're supercharged. It's so, so important to be energized at the start line. It's so important. So that's why up to this point, you're here with that anxious moment that you're going to give your best performance in the next 2 weeks. So now, let's talk about priming the body. What does that mean? You basically increase the blood circulation. So before the event, you need to tell your body that, you know what, the neuromuscular system should be aware that, yes, there is a event coming up. Okay, you're not telling a 10K event, but you're preparing your body to be ready to give your best performance. So what you can do is, these are small things that you can do. You can do, let's say today, tomorrow, you can do a four to six time short strides. When I say short stride, at the race pace for about 20 seconds, run continuously, run for 20 seconds, short strides, and take a recovery of about another 20 to 30 seconds or even a minute. Just walk back the distance. Okay, you can run back and forth for about 6 times. Or if you don't have a space for running, or you don't want to run, you can even do a short stride inside the, you know, get into the gym, a bike, and do the spinning, and then, or swim, get in the swimming pool. Swimming pool, the best thing is it's non-impact, it is not very tiresome, and you're not going to create any damage. That's why I said I'm putting a time limit of about 5 to 10 minutes. So don't overdo this, you're going to be fatigued and you're not ready for the race then. And then very important thing is, watch your hydration. The earlier session, we had an expert talking about the hydration. So what kind of, right now you should be drinking sips and sips of water right now. If you're not drinking water, then probably you're not doing the right thing. Okay, you should have a bottle, keep sipping water. You don't need to load with half a liter of water. And then also avoid spicy and fibrous food. Spicy food, your digestive system is going to be damaged, and the fibrous food, it is going to take a lot of time to digest. On the Wednesday morning and Sunday morning, you will have issues in clearing up your tummy. Okay, so that's why you need to avoid this. And then again, good rest. Shadow run, what I call as a shadow run, is basically playing the race day in your mind. Close your eyes, think about the start line, think about how you're going to run the race, first kilometer, second kilometer, fifth kilometer, and then dashing to the finish, opening your arms wide and, you know, letting that entire energy coming out of you, give the best shot, right? So this is playing the race in the mind. It really, really helps you to achieve success on that particular day. And then finally, sleep. I put a star there. All of you know the star means there is a condition supply. Please do not try to sleep. The sleep should be a natural process. The moment you try to sleep, you will never get a sleep. How many of you agree with me? If you try to sleep, you cannot get a sleep. It should be a natural process that needs to take care of your bringing your body to the rest. So that's why I believe in meditating. My wife is a yoga teacher. She teaches me a lot about meditation. Just calm down, sit in one quiet place, listen to your favorite music. Do not watch TV, don't WhatsApp, don't Facebook. Just listen to the soothing music and take rest. Okay, so the sleep is, it's a conditional one. Even if you don't sleep on that day before the event, don't fret about this. Don't have the feeling at the start and, oh my God, I did not sleep today. So that itself is going to stress you out. Okay, so stay relaxed. So now this is priming the body. Now, very, very important thing. I'm going to run through this quickly. Charge, charge, charge. We talked about charging your body, but don't forget to charge your Garmin. You don't want to see a dead Garmin at the start line. Maybe your phone, you want to listen to your iPod music. You don't want to miss that opportunity. And also, your dress, the apparel that you're going to wear, make sure that it's the same apparel that you've tried, tested. So it's really important. The shoes is the same. And I'm sure some of you are excited buying some products here, but keep it with you, because you need to train them before you basically use them in a race. And then very important thing is the Vaseline on Band-Aid are the best buddies, because I've seen many male runners running with bleeding nipples. At the finish line, you see there's a lot of blood coming, you know, they look like war heroes, okay, because they have the bleeding nipples. Very simple thing, you smear Vaseline or put the Band-Aid. There are a lot of non-chafing products available in the market, you use that. It's really important. And also take care of your toes. Sometimes even the toes need Vaseline so that you can avoid friction and then no blisters at the end of, at the start line, at the finish line, you don't want to walk away with the big time blisters. And then also many times I've seen runners struggling to run the race and somebody else pointing, even tripping and falling with their own lace which is not tied properly. So you can always put a safety knot twice, you tie it so that the race is not going to come, okay, very easily. Now, what's your target finish time? Okay, this is a question. Somebody said 1 hour. Are you going to run tomorrow? What's your target finish time? Is anybody running 10K tomorrow? What's your target finish time, sir? 55 minutes. Okay. What is that? 40 minutes. 40 minutes? 52. All right, 52 minutes. Anybody else? Who is not going to worry about the finish time tomorrow? Who's not going to worry about the finish time tomorrow? All right. So go for it, right? Whatever is your target, go for it. It's really, really important that when you finish any event that you signed up for, you can consider yourself as a hero. I've done a lot of ultra marathons. The feeling is the same, whether it's 10K, 5K, or an 90 kilometers ultra, or even I've done it 12 hours inside the continuous stadium, continuously running about 85 kilometers. The feeling is the same. It feels amazing. You feel like a hero at the end of the day. Now, what are the race day demands? Okay, so I put a little star there. So this is really important. I'm going to talk about that. The first thing is clean up, right? So the first thing in the morning, you get up. And I'm assuming at 5:30, you're starting the race at 5:30. So you're getting up at least 2-3 hours before. Okay, and you need to clean up. You know, make sure that you're cleaning up your system. And then fuel. The earlier session we talked about, we understood the need for simple carbohydrate and some amount of protein. Avoid fatty food, avoid fibrous food. So you can have anything like 100 to 200 or 200 to 300 calories, depending upon the size of the body. Okay, so for me, a 200 to 300 calorie food 2 hours before the race is good enough. And for somebody who's larger than me, might need additional 100 calories. And then reach the venue on time. I've seen many people rushing into the venue last minute, anticipate traffic jam. There is going to be piling up of runners. You need to reach here even an hour before, come here. You know, there's not a problem. 4:30, sink in the feeling. The ambience is so electrifying. You need to really, really feel that you're part of it. Come here about an hour before the race and it's really, really fantastic. Okay, and then parking your car, you don't need to worry about putting your goodie bag in there. You check in your personal items, and all these things are going to take time. And then again, the porta potties, there are going to be a long queue. Okay, so you want to basically pee, and you know, you don't have place to pee, and there's going to be a lot of queue there. Factor in that time. 30 minutes before the race, make sure you go and stand in the line. By the time you get access to the porta potty, you're basically ready to pee, right? And then that is absolutely freedom, because you cannot run at the 5K. You cannot look for a porta potty, which is going to kill your time. And your performance efficiency is going to go down. And then really important to warm up. One star condition applying, warning that I would like to give you. Warm up, any exercises that you have been doing to warm up, don't try anything new on the race day, okay? And I'm sure there's going to be Zumba, there's going to be music. I've seen many people doing a 10K warm up before the event. Okay, so you don't have to commit to that kind of warm up. Just need about, depending upon your performance, 5 minutes or 10 minutes warm up, whatever is your warm up routine, please do that. And then during the run, fuel is really important. And I was told that the ORS, you can see there's the ORSL Plus, this is going to be available during the run. Now, all of you know that as far as your calorie demand is concerned, if you're going to run or walk for 2 hours, let's say somebody is the slowest runner, is going to take about 2 hours, you need at least 300 calories an hour. So this drink is about, you can see 200 ml, and serving size is 200 ml, serving per container is, you can see nutrition information per 100 ml, so 200 ml, you need to multiply this by 2. So that means if you drink the whole thing, what you get is 100 calories. Okay. So if you are having two of these waters per hour, that is going to take care of your calorie needs during the bath. Okay. And this also has amino acid called taurine. It's directly going to help you with the repair during the run, and some minerals which are needed for electrolytes. Basically, your chlorides are there, your potassium is there, so that sodium is there. So the oral replenishment needs are taken care of by this drink. Okay, but if you are used to having gels or your own personal, electrolyte, please go for that. You don't have to try anything. But this will take it. Just to give you an indication, the SEMM, the Mumbai Marathon. I did pacing for somebody for 5 hours. The entire 5 hours, I've actually run the entire run with water solution. Maybe one or two bananas in between. You don't need any solids for this. If you have 1 hour runner, you don't need any solids. Body has enough stored energy for you to take you to the finish line. Okay. Now, pacing during the run, you know, go with your pacing strategy. Don't try anything new. The beginning of the race is where the most excitement is. There are going to be a lot of runners who are going to run faster than your pace. I remember the first time I ran my 21K race, I was running with the elite runners. You know, the elite runners, they run 20, 21 kilometers an hour speed. I was running with them. Within 2 minutes, I felt that there is something going wrong in my system. When I looked at my Garmin, it said that I was running at 320 pace. Okay, so then I had to show down, slow down, you know, make sure that I'm running at my own pace. So it's really important that you pace. And once you finish the race, cool down and refuel. Once you finish the race, it's really important for you to eat something. And the fuel stations are available. And the post-run rehydration is also available. Make sure that you're doing. And then do stretches. It's my personal experience. Do stretches about 30 minutes after you complete run. We don't try to stretch immediately after you run. The body is in a totally agitated state. You might even get some additional cramps. You really don't want to experiment with stretching. So wait for about 20 minutes and then do proper stretching before you get inside the car. Okay. Now, the rest and recovery post-race is really, really important. General recommendation is you keep sipping the water throughout the day. You don't need to gulp. 500 ml of water in one go. I'm sure a lot of people try this water therapies, but actually there is no need. You don't want to load your kidney unnecessarily. Okay. And rest and recover. So this also means that go and have a nice sleep. Okay, please do not drink alcohol. Okay, so the recover, having fun and celebration, you definitely don't want to mix alcohol with it, at least for the next 2-3 days. And nutritious food is important. You need those vitamins to be replaced. You need the minerals to be replaced. And then the best carbohydrate sources are there. And then, of course, you need to celebrate your success and retrospect. I'm from the project management community. I always like to look back and see what I did right, what I did not do right. What is that I should be doing better? So these are some of the respective views. So now let's quickly get into this. You can see this diagram, you remember that. Make sure that you're asking these right questions. Now, what are the various forces against you? So we have seen how to prime the body. We have seen what to do up to the race. And we've already ready and you've run the race completely. You've rested, recovered. What are the things that can work against you on the race? Any guesses? Anybody, can you tell what can go wrong on that day? What can go wrong on the day? Anybody? What can go wrong on the day? Only kids seem to be excited here. Anybody else? What can go wrong on the day? Sorry? Unknowns? Ghosts? Sorry? Oh, the weather. Okay, the weather. All right. The weather can be a problem. Okay, let's talk about this. So the untimely party, right? So I'm sure this is really, really a problem. Okay, make sure that you get this right. If you're a marathon runner, you know how to do this correctly, okay? Until the time you're still, okay, you cannot call yourself as a good marathon runner. Humidity is going to be around, I checked the weather, and it's about 88%. But one good news is we are starting the race at 5:30 in the morning, so you don't need to really, there's going to be a cool breeze. Temperature is not going to be bothering you, so you don't really need to worry about humidity. And then medication. I've seen many runners taking hypertensive medicines. Okay, medicines for diabetes, medicines for hypertensive. Know your limits. Talk to your doctors. Make sure that, because some of these medication has a wrong combination of effects. You can have a counterproductive effect if you are drinking some fluids, which can even create some kind of upset tummy, right? So you don't want to really risk that. And then crowd, if you are starting in the back, you're trying to cut through the crowd, it is going to be a problem. Mishap, you don't want to roll and fall on the ground. So these are things important. And then plus you're trying something new on that day. Like for example, you bought a shoe here and you want to go wear that, you know, something is not fitting in your legs correctly. So you're trying a new apparel which is kind of chafing and which is tight. You don't want to really experiment those things. Or maybe somebody came and said, I've got a pacing chart for 10 kilometers. Can you follow this? Please avoid all those things. And then sudden fitness ambitions. Don't hit the gym today. Okay, stay away from fitness, stay away from, you know, push-ups, stay away, because your upper body endurance is really, really important. You don't want to tire your muscles, okay? You cannot build any fitness today to give a better performance. There are no shortcuts, okay? That's why I said there are absolutely no shortcuts. And then again, I've also seen runners going for a 40 kilometers, 50 kilometers, 200 kilometers ride after the race. Please understand your body has gone through a very, very stressful time giving your best performance. You don't want to further disturb that by riding, or any repetitive movement need to be avoided. You can take a taxi, go home, or get a ride from somebody who's not running on the day, and then you can get back home safely. All right? Very important request. I've seen many, many races. I've run many, many races. This aspect is something that always worries me, and I'm sure all of you are responsible citizens, but also runners need to be very, very responsible when it comes to protecting the beauty of this fantastic city, Bangalore. Okay, so use the garbage bins. So when you finish the ORS solution, just keep it in your hand. Whenever you see the next garbage bin, throw it, or maybe somewhere closer to the bin. Don't just like that throw it inside the, let's say the flower gardens, or maybe by the side of the road, inside the gutter. So let's make sure that this is one of the cleanest races, okay, as per standards. And then again, discipline and patience. Sometimes you have to give way. Somebody wants to go ahead of you. There is no race. You're not competing. You're not competing against somebody else. So you need to give way to somebody who wants to go ahead of you. Okay, so make sure you give way. And another thing is, listen to your body. Listen to your body at any point of time you feel that something is, let's say you have a chest pain, you experience some really, really bad cramps, just retire. That's okay. You can come here and run the next year, or you can look for another event where you can come and give your best performance. Okay. Now, one before we wind up, I would like to ask you one question. Who's an elite runner? Who can give the definition of an elite runner? Who are the elite runners? Elite runners? Anybody? Are you struggling to find? Yes, who's the elite runner, sir?
The ones have, those who have some different timings from the normal people. Mainly they are a bit extraordinary, but if we try, we can overcome that.
Okay, all right, he says that they're not normal people who can run like crazy, right? So they are considered as the elite runner. So you have a definition, elite runner?
Hello. So for this race especially, the elite runner would be someone running the race within 25 minutes, 30 minutes.
Alright, somebody who runs this race 10k in 35 minutes, elite runner. But I slightly differ with your views. You are an elite runner. Each one of us here, are elite runners. The reason is very simple. Okay, reason is very simple. We are all very different. We have our unique ambitions, unique dreams, and we need to chase that. Okay, and I'm sure there is a technical definition of elite runners, you know, world-class runners and all those things. But this race is not a competition for most of us. So you're competing against you, right? So your dreams you're trying to overcome, and then very, very interestingly, it is between you yesterday versus today versus tomorrow. Okay, so that's why I personally feel that each one of us are very, very elite in our own senses, okay? All right, and lastly, you need to chill out, right? It's just a 10K race. You can imagine that it is going to be fun. And then have super fun. Okay, with this, I would like to thank you so much for this opportunity. Thanks to Mr. Venkat and also ProCamp for letting me share my experiences about this race and event. I really enjoyed preparing this content. It's kind of looking back and digging my memory to bring out the best, you know, from my own experiences and also presenting and sharing with you. all the best for your run.
Coach, before I ask if anybody else has any questions, I am going to touch upon two parts of the presentation that really connected with me. The first part is, you know, you said, are you a responsible runner? And I just loved the three points that you made. In all this aspect of running, speed, performance, training, nutrition, we forget to have fun and we forget to be responsible. So one of the things that I wanted to add there is that thank the volunteers, okay? Thank the police, thank the pacers who are coming and volunteering. There are pacers there are, we got 18 of them. They are sacrificing the race. There's one coming from Goa, there are four coming from Chennai, there's one coming from Hyderabad, and they're all paid money just like you and me. They're taking flights, they're staying in hotels, and they're going to run slower than what they could have normally run, so that the runners can have a better experience. So we definitely, that the least we can do is express gratitude. The cop who's standing there at the signal and stopping the traffic got up at 3 a.m. and came and stood there. You are hydrated, but he also has an untimely potty incident, okay? And he cannot leave, okay? At least thank him, okay? So that really is something that I really did. I really liked your aspect of, you know, who is an elite runner. We tend to think that only the runner who runs fast is an elite runner. But I have often held that the runner who comes last is as much to be, you know, acknowledged as the runner who comes first. Because the runner who comes first is running throughout his life. You know, he's got a coach, he's got a massage, he's got a physio, he's got everything going for him to come running fast. But the runner who comes last, you know, he's running in spite of several adversaries that probably would have made him not run on that day. You know, but he still came there. So I think the acknowledgement to the runner who comes first is much needed, as much as to the runner who comes last. So thank you very much, Coach. I mean, really very good presentation. I can see the efforts that you made into, you know, into that kind of a thing. For those who don't know, Coach ran 42 full marathons over successive 42 weekends. Please give a big hand. And he didn't do this to run fast and get some prize money. He ran this to pass the message of road accidents. There are more people dying in India from road accidents than cancer or from heart disease or from AIDS or any of the other things that we keep talking of, okay? So road accidents are the single biggest killer, and Coach ran 42 successive weekends to pass the message of, you know, eliminating or if not curbing road accidents in the country. Thank you very much, Coach. Are there any questions?
Last from 1 year, I'm practicing running. And I'm not reducing my weight, I'm increasing my weight. I don't know why it is. Already I have 68 I was, and now I'm 70. But comfortably I can run 10K. But I don't know how it is. I want to reduce my weight.
Certainly, that's a very, very long topic to discuss. Maybe after this event, I can connect with you. Because weight, that's why I said this session is all about the next 48 hours, and losing weight is not possible within that time. Okay? So, miracle, only miracle can happen. So, I don't believe in miracles. So, we'll talk about that after this session. Okay? So, there could be training method, there could be diet. There could be, you know, so your sleeping habits, eating habits, a lot of lifestyle, many, many factors affect somebody's weight loss, even some of the genetic conditions. So we can discuss this after these events. Thank you. Any other questions?
Well, thank you for coming very much. From ProCamp, this is a very small token of our gratitude. Thank you very much. You took a lot of effort to make this presentation. Thank you very much.